What's good?
Hey.
What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? How you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. I'm like, you know, I'm kind of recovering. You know, I just came back from the gym.
Just came back from the gym.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting in here just finished eating. Ain't that some stuff?
Yeah, you need to come on out there with me.
Yeah, I would, but you know, the way my ankles set up and my knees, you know, my hip bone connected to my thigh bone. And my knees and my ankle and my elbow and my, yeah.
It's like that.
Yeah, so, you know, my posterior kind of tight with the chair, and they got this bun that.
Well, you know, if you come on to the gym, we can work that on out.
You know, my posterior and this chair, they got a bun. Every time I get up, it looks the same. It is molded to my shape.
Oh, okay.
Box Chevy.
All righty.
Yo, it is the CIg Gnac Show. I'm your guy, DJ White Bread, and this is my girl, me.
Yeah.
So, check it out. Today, man, we got a lot of stuff to talk about, man. I am so glad to be back. As y'all can see, we are not together tonight.
You and me must never part.
Oh, you finished?
Yeah. I wasn't gonna do the whole thing.
Oh, I was gonna bend it over.
Really, dude.
Hey, you know, it is what it is. Hey, I like them colors behind your head. Is that your favorite color or something?
Blue is one of my favorite colors. It is.
Like prison stripes.
You would go there.
Hey, gotta do it, gotta do it. Yo, but tonight, man, we got a lot of stuff to talk about. Oh, I was saying before I start talking about that, we're not together tonight, yo. I got a little cough, and I don't want her to get sick.
Oh, ain't that tweet.
Oh. Okay, I'm not sick. I don't have COVID. I think I just got a little cold, got a little cough, but she's sickly.
Man,
I'm just playing. She is not sickly, y'all. You know, she might have cooties every now and again, but she is not sickly.
Really?
Yo, hey. Have you ever had the cooties?
No.
Okay, you never had the cooties. No. All right. So, you know, I mean, we're here on the CIg Gnac Show, and we would like to know, has Miss Yak ever had cooties?
No, I have not. Have you?
No, I have not had cooties, but you have kissed boys, and when you kiss boys, you have cooties.
Well, that would mean that you already had them, huh?
No, I don't have cooties because I don't kiss boys. I kiss girls. Oh, man. See, you can't win with me. Got a little. Y'all know how to finish eating.
You got leftovers?
You feel a little piece of meat like stuck in your tooth. You be like,
yeah, you're getting them leftovers.
Yeah, that was pretty good. That was pretty good. But yo, today, man, we got a lot of stuff we're gonna talk about, man. We're gonna get into this show. But before we do, there's been a lot of stuff going on in the news this week. Like a whole lot of stuff going on in the news. Let me get my notes out because you know. Somebody told me I didn't take notes and I didn't prep well for the show, so I have notes.
Look at you trying to be all business like and things.
I'm not just texting folks while I'm on the show. I'm actually looking at my notes. So this segment of the
professional.
Say what?
Trying to be all professional.
Professionally.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if we want to take it to the next level, we got to do things this way and get it to that level. So, Miss Yak.
Yes.
I am proposing to you live on the air in front of
all
the
time.
No. Hell no. Wait a minute. Hold up. Oh, shit. Wait. Oh, man. I said I wasn't going to curse.
Scared the crap out of you.
Hold on. Back it up. Shit. You, hold on. God damn. You, ooh, God damn. You just, I don't know what the hell you. What the fuck? Man, I bet your mama listening to this show too, ain't she? Probably over there talking, like, yes! Yes! And your dad probably like, yeah! Finally got him!
Man, hush.
Got me smoking. Mmm. You got me smoking, and I ain't smoking no cigar on the air in a while.
It's like that.
You got me right there. Shit. Hey. I got to rethink my words with you, because you just got me with that one. I am suggesting
a
new segment that we used to do, that you used to do. What was it called? The
celebrity.
The celebrity. But you know, I don't. The celebrity was just you.
Mm-hmm.
And since you're doing girl talk with Miss Yak, and that's just you, I don't feel like you need to just do celebrity by yourself over here. That's just me being me. So, what I am gonna call this is just plain and simple what it is in the news, or we can say in the news.
Okay.
We're going to let them get naked in the nude. That's what we're going to call it, in the nude. Y'all like that? Y'all like in the nude?
Okay. We're just bearing it all.
It worked. Oh, confirmation. Yeah, in the nude, because we bear it all. So we're going to get a whole little intro type deal for it. And so I'm just going to fake one right now for it. Today on In the Nude. Wow.
Yeah, that's gonna need some work.
If we got some musicians out there that want to give us a little 10-second or so intro for In the Nude, please. All right, so first thing we got on In the Nude, your boy, Miss Yak.
R.
Kelly is guilty.
Shoot, he ain't no boy mine.
Guilty. He is guilty, 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 guilty. Y'all knew that was happening, right?
Of course.
Y'all knew that was coming.
It's about time.
Y'all knew it was coming. Y'all knew it was coming. He been, for years, he been peeing on the girls. Sneaky linking before they were sneaky leaking.
Mm-hmm.
All that kind of stuff. R. Kelly, you my dude, you my homie, you my boy, Robert. But you got caught, man.
But
you got caught. Now, I ain't do no stuff like that. I ain't finna get caught, because I ain't doing nothing like that. You might get the little girl, but I'm going up to their mamas. That's what I'm going to do.
That's what you gonna do?
That's what. I'm going after the mamas, because you can't just be. You can't just go after the little girls. Can't go after the little girls, because you know I smoke cigars. I mean, you know, you smoke a cigar, and you round there and round them little girls. And they go in the house. Their mama be like, Star Keisha, who you been over there with? Shaquan, what you been in there doing? Give me the mirror.
So okay, wait. So you gonna put this whole situation on the parents of the victims?
Mm-mm. I ain't even put nothing on them. They played their part.
In some cases, I would say, yeah.
They gave this man them they They thought they was in Africa or something, having arranged marriages. That's what I think. So, and it wasn't even a marriage. It was some arranged booty.
Really, dude?
That's what it was. That's what it was. I think that's what it was.
Arranged booty.
Yep. In the nude. We're bearing it all. But I got one question. I saw a post on Facebook.
Okay, what you see?
Somebody asked, what's the difference between R. Kelly and that dude driving the box Chevy that used to pick some of y'all asses up from school during lunch?
What?
Now, you know in high school, it was girls that was leaving school, skipping school with them old, grown, rusty dudes during lunch going, you know, getting their little freak on and coming back. Mm-hmm. Don't be bucking your eyes because you was the one that was running home sneaking with your with your boyfriend to come back to school before your folks got there.
No.
Oh, you just used to do it after school. Okay, I got it.
You ain't gonna do me like that. But I do recall, you know, back in the day, yeah, there were some girls who were like, I would say, you know, your typical gold diggers. They go for the older guys who got the nice cars and stuff like that. And so yeah, they were doing stuff like that. I've never been the materialistic type though. So that flashy stuff didn't get me.
So that flashy stuff didn't get you?
No.
Okay, I got you. But, you know, it's neither here nor there. Your man, you know, R. Kelly, you gonna make some new music while you in there, bro.
I don't know if he wanna make that type of music.
Suddenly he feel like he gonna break loose.
Oh my goodness.
Silly gonna get him busting his dude.
That you wrong for that. You are so wrong for that.
Hey, he gonna come out there. He gonna be like, secret lovers undercover on the DL getting busy.
Ain't no secrets up in there.
Hey, he ain't gonna want nobody to know.
Everybody gonna already assume anyway.
What's another one? What's another one? One. We'll go to the sale of fun. Two.
You is too much.
Announce and give him your tongue. Three. Cause tonight he's gonna make you his fantasy. Yeah.
That's what we doing.
Four. Get your ass on the floor. Five, he gonna make himself come inside.
Ooh, you nasty.
He said, he ain't worried about it being broken. He gonna fit.
You is nasty.
Seven, he gonna spread his cheeks apart.
Eight.
Y'all, I'm sorry. Hey, I mean, shit, R. Kelly, you did that to yourself. All right, so we gotta change that because I'm going crazy, man. They gonna kill him in there. They're gonna kill him. They gonna kill him. They're gonna tear that thing up and they're gonna kill him. They're gonna kill him. Just like the media has tried to kill my girl. The media has tried to kill my girl. Kelly Price. They were out there saying that she was dead. First, they said that she was kidnapped, and then they turned around and said she was dead.
Nobody knew what was going on.
All right. So, a couple of days ago, she came out and she broke her silence,
mm-hmm.
and she said no, she was not missing. She was not missing. She said this. She was not missing. She had COVID. She mm-hmm. was released from the hospital and she went home under quarantine. And the reason that the boyfriend was not letting anybody in was because she was under quarantine.
The thing is this though. Okay, I blame this whole situation on Kelly because even, you know, if she was as sick as she was, she still could let family know. He could have told her family, yeah, she's okay. She's you know, dealing with this COVID or whatever, but she's in the quarantine. If they had communicated to her family, all this would have never even happened.
But see, the thing about it is, they probably did communicate to some of the family, the need to know. This might
her
be...
Her sister?
Nah, I don't know, nah. It was her sister that said she didn't know what she was?
Yes.
Her sister could be the messy one. I mean, I'm just saying, every family got one. Am I right or wrong? Every family got the messy one.
I suppose.
Because you know, it's some folks you don't want to know, you don't want to know nothing about what's going on in your house.
Yeah.
You don't want your little messy cousin to know that you got that sex swing in your bedroom behind the door, hanging on that little hook, and you got pop-up pole that you screw up and tighten up so that you can get freaking, and then that box of toys that's up under your bed on the...
You getting very descriptive.
Left side where you...
Are you talking about your own room?
My room ain't big enough for no pole.
Hey, where there's a will, there's a way.
And shit, I flipped the mattress up on the side. We finna do this. I got a whole house. We can go through it. I can put the pole in the front room and walk through that baby naked. I have no problem with that. I'm sexy naked.
I think your kids would disagree.
No. They got to be gone for at least 20 minutes. I just need 20 minutes. That's all. Just need a good 20, man. Just 20. That's all.
That's all you need is 20.
20 minutes. Hey, Bernie Mac said it ain't but 37 pumps. Y'all better listen to him. I don't need but 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, I can get about 370 pumps in.
All right.
So Kelly Price, she ain't dead.
Yeah, she's alive, and I'm happy to hear
it. I had to bring that back.
Because the way that it came out in the media, it seemed so sketchy.
Yeah, it did, and it was crazy. You know, hey, I love the fact that she's back. Now, the reason I was reading an article today,
mm-hmm.
and I can kind of see how they think she was dead. Because she said in the article that she died and came back, like from COVID or whatever. She died.
Oh, wow.
So they probably just look like, yeah, she dead. Ooh. Reading is fundamental. Read to the end. Got to see it through, my boy. Ooh, I see you yawning.
Told y'all came went to the gym today.
Hey, that my man, what's his name? Justin with, what's it, Refresh?
Refresh Fitness. He has been working me out for the past, mm-hmm. what?
Did you do the squats? Working on them glutes?
No, we worked on my abs today.
I thought you was going to say you worked on your ass today. I was going to say, I was being nice with
you. We worked on my abs today.
Hey, it is what it is. That's what y'all want to call it. Hey, but get out.
But yes, Justin from Refresh Fitness. You can find him on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter.
Hey, that's my boy, but he don't get no free advertising. Don't be doing that. Don't be doing that. Mm-mm, nope. And now he gonna probably text me in a little while. I'll be like, dog, you know you're wrong. I'm like, all right, short man.
But look at here.
It is what it is.
But look at here. Is he really doing it? Is it really free advertising if he's helping you?
You know what? I'm kind of scared to get in the gym with him because he all this shit I've been talking about him. That joker probably will try to kill me. I feel like I'm in basic training all over again.
No, he ain't that bad.
Like, shoot, he got short man syndrome. He gonna be, ooh,
Lord. Don't do the man like that.
I mean, he ain't but 4'11".
Don't do the man like that.
Tell me he ain't 4'11".
I have no idea how tall he really is.
Okay, can you see the top of his head when you stand up beside him?
I am not going to talk about my coach. So you will not do me.
Mm.
Next.
If you You be telling him to look up at you, don't you? Be like, look up at me.
I am not. You are not going to goat me, white bread.
That's why when he had you doing them workouts, he'd be like, squat, squat. Because he want to look at you in your face.
Wrong for that.
Hey, Justin, you my boy. You my boy. Solid. Hey, but it is what it is. Sometimes things just work out the way that they work out. Kind of like that marriage, man. Will and Jada. That's another one. In the nude. In the nude. Will and Jada.
But are we really surprised? Are we surprised by this?
You know what? Actually, I'm not, because it is what it is. But to be honest, to be all the way honest, I think, okay, let's bring everybody up to speed if they don't know. Y'all know last year it came out about the entanglement with August Alsina, I think.
Was it just last year? It seemed like it was longer than that.
Last year, year before last, whenever it was, they had the little entanglement.
Right.
And Jada was doing that, and Will sat at the table looking all sour, like he was just so hurt that she did this. No, bro, you was hurt because she was doing it out in public. But now that you went through your counseling and talking to your life coach and all this stuff, and it came out that y'all had this agreement before this dude was in place. You been out there doing your thing. She been out there doing her thing, but y'all still married. So Will and Jada believes that just because you are married, you do not have to be monogamous. Is that the right word?
Yeah, they don't believe in the conventional marriage.
Yeah, so.
But he apparently, you know, he apparently struggled with that due to his Christian upbringing. And so it initially bothered him, but apparently he got over it. Because
you gonna get over
that's what they just said. That's what they said. I think, but you know what? You know, because we're gonna get all off, go left field or whatever. But you know,
hold on, wait a minute.
Oh Lord,
it didn't win out.
Because you know, the Bible tells you your thoughts are sins as well.
Okay, so.
But. I think a lot of people overlook that, or they ignore that. Cause I mean, your thoughts are your thoughts. I mean, you know, you really can't control your thoughts to a certain extent. So it's like, basically everybody is sinners. And you know, if you want, truthfully, we're all sinners. So that's something that you really can't get around or whatnot. So that's something that he struggled with, and just because of his Christian upbringing and whatnot. And so, I mean, I don't know. Me personally, it's like the whole situation with their open marriage and whatnot, that's something that was put out in the news like, 20 years ago or whatever. And there are rumors about it. But the thing is this, whose business is it if you are not Will and Jada? Huh?
For real. It'll be my business because, you know, I might be one of Jada's boys.
Okay.
I mean, if it's like that and I can, why should I not?
I'm not disputing that. I don't understand, you know, I mean, I do understand, but I don't understand why the media made such a big deal out of what goes on behind the doors of a happily married couple. Whether they decide that they want to be monogamous or not, that's up to them. That's what works for them. Everybody's marriage is different.
Right. Exactly. Now, everybody's marriage is different. But, you know, you said just a minute ago talking about, you know, the Bible and the Christian and the everybody, the thoughts that make you sin, you know, sin, all that mm-hmm. stuff you just said.
Mm-hmm.
Will said in an article that I read. Yeah, I've been reading, y'all.
I'm so proud of you.
I'm coming over me now. I'm not just looking at TV. Now I'm reading. But I read the article, and he said that when he was talking to his life coach, he realized that he had been having thoughts of like the African kings from back when he was little, having multiple wives. And you know, if they financially could afford the wives, that mean they can have them, right?
Mm-hmm. So I suppose.
So he financially could afford Jada and 10 other women.
Yeah, but he then also said just the thought of that, when he really sat down and thought about it, he was like, that would be horrible.
Man, that's a lot of work.
That is a lot of work to have.
That's a lot of.
I mean, I've seen the reality shows of those polygamy relationships, and it'd be like one guy and like 3-4 plus women.
That's too many.
Sister wives.
That's too many.
That's a big headache. One guy,
two girls, you happy. But they can't be in the same house all the time because y'all women, when y'all be in the same house, y'all cycle start to kind of go get together. And the whole idea behind that is if your cycle is there, hers better not be, because somebody got to be able to perform.
Really, dude.
It's just a thought.
So you are for polygamy?
I am, actually.
Oh, really?
I am. Mm. Whatever makes you happy. You know what I'm saying? Whatever makes you happy. Now, don't get me wrong. You can be, I don't know how it's going to work, but you can be in a polygamous relationship with one person.
What, she break out all her wigs?
No. Most of y'all women bipolar.
What?
Y'all have like 18 different personalities. Bipolar, tripolar, quadpolar, all of that.
So that's what you mean by a polygamous relationship?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, whatever. I mean, you know, sometimes it might be fun to have one down here, you know, y'all just be like,
okay.
Can we stay PG-13? Because you almost made me go to Pornhub.
I almost made you.
Yeah, you almost made me go to Pornhub.
How did I almost make you do that?
Start thinking about them two women.
What two women?
Whatever two pop up. Lord, have mercy.
Uh-huh.
I am a sinner. Probably gonna sin again. Poor thing. Lord, forgive me. Hey, but so... Okay, Will and Jada, they doing what they do in their bedroom, and that's just plain and simple what it is. That brings us up to our topic of the evening. Our topic of the evening is, ladies and gentlemen, watch out. It's hobosexual season. Yeah. Hobosexual. 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 Not a homosexual.
Because
I said last week, I will not talk about homosexuals because I am a grown ass man and I will not get my ass kicked by a man with a boyfriend.
Please don't. That would not be a good look.
Because first of all, you ain't fighting them. Because they don't fight one on one. You fight one, you got 10 coming out the car, taking off fingernails and wigs. And how you going to fight a man that got on a halter top? You a grown ass man trying to fight a man with a halter top on. How you going to do that?
Mm.
All right. So what is a hobosexual?
Please enlighten us.
What is a hobosexual? Okay, so I was looking up on the Urban Dictionary.
Mm-hmm.
And a hobosexual, I can't find my notes, but a hobosexual is I'm paraphrasing. You like that word, don't you? I'm paraphrasing. A hobosexual is a person who engages in a relationship only to have a place to live. A person who engages in a relationship only to have a place to live.
Only to have a place to live.
Only.
Only.
So basically, that's a lot of homosexuals out here. So who is a homosexual? Who can be a homosexual?
Well, anybody can be a homosexual. Anybody who is unemployed and is seeking a companionship from the opposite sex.
So anybody that's unemployed and seeking companionship from the opposite sex.
Yes.
Is homosexual. That is partly true.
Partly true.
Partly true. Partly true. I'll give you half credit for that.
Okay.
Now, I know of a girl right now. She's probably listening. If she's listening, I'm not going to say your name, but you know who I'm talking about. You know I'm talking about you. This girl was living with her boyfriend, with her daughter. Her boyfriend and her daughter.
Okay.
Her and her boyfriend got into it. She left. She stayed in a hotel for a couple days till her money got funny. I'm saying a couple, but it was probably about 2-3 weeks till her money got funny.
Okay.
She engaged in a relationship with a lesbian so that she could move in with her.
What?
So she was a homosexual. Now, she still was with dudes, but she was with that girl so she could have somewhere to live.
Okay. I see what you're saying.
So she was a low down dirty lick'em lower.
Okay. So, wait. So she was okay. Bisexual, or she was acting homosexual just for a residence?
She was acting homosexual just for a residence. The girl even would tell you she had never been with a girl before that girl. She just knew that she needed somewhere to stay. The lesbian came on to her and she went with it. She offered and she took up her offer.
So how long did she stay with her?
Man, they was together for a good little minute. Told girl got on her feet, got her some, you know, got a little money saved up.
So she's basically bisexual.
I guess you can call her bisexual now. But yeah, she was trisexual then because she sure tried it.
Boy, hush.
She did try it. I guess she tried it and she liked it. I guess she tried it and she liked it.
I guess so.
Yeah, and so the reason that I went on to put that story out there first, because when folks think about homosexuals, they always think that it's a man.
Yeah, I can see that. But I can also see the females, though.
Man. Hey, time out.
What?
I got to pause this. We're going to come back to this. Somebody out there shooting like hell. I'ma make you pump like that.
Fucking more! now back to your regularly scheduled program.
All right, we back, y'all, man. Hey, yo, that was, I don't know what just happened.
Yeah.
I don't know what just the hell happened.
Well, a little scary.
Hello, how are you?
A little scary. I'm good.
You okay? Did it scare you?
A little bit.
Shit, it almost got me too, you know. All right, so maybe somebody found out that the person that they was with was not really homosexual. They was just a hobosexual. And they let that thing sing. All right, so what just happened, y'all? And I said I wasn't going to tell y'all, but right outside the my house here, which it don't normally happen over here, it was a few gunshots. So that's why I was like, wait a minute. And it sounded close, like it was right outside.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and since I'm at home, Miss Jack is at home. My son is back there. I stopped to go check on my son. You know, he's good. We good. I ain't going to look and see if nobody laying in the street because I'm sorry. I've seen too many movies where you go out there to check on somebody and you get popped because they want to make sure that they down. I'm going to let the folks that job that is come do their job. That's my job when I'm in the clinic, but I'm at the home.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I apologize for that, y'all. All right, so hobosexuals. The girl, she was trisexual. Okay.
Okay.
She was trisexual. So I have a question for you. Now, okay. Let me go before I ask this question. Women are hobosexuals just like men. But 9 times out of 10, when you think of a hobosexual, they try to put it on men.
They try to put it on men. There are men hobosexuals.
Oh, yeah, it's some out there. But you got to admit, there's women out there, too.
I did admit it. I do agree with that.
Okay, I just want to make sure that we're on the same page. So, you know, they out there. All right. Have you ever had a hobosexual?
I think I have.
Oh, what they said? You got to tell me.
Yeah, I have.
You had a hobosexual?
It wasn't, I mean, of course, I didn't go into it like that, but I don't think nobody actually goes into it like that, but that's basically what it was. So.
So you nobody actually goes into it like that?
No, who goes into it wanting to be with a hobosexual?
They do. They know what they're doing.
So you're saying that there's people out there that want people to mooch off of them?
No, not the one that's getting mooched.
That's what I said.
The moocher, the moochie.
Yeah, that's what I said. I said nobody goes into it wanting to be with a hobosexual.
But they are.
You're still not following me.
Okay. Just say you come move in with me. You don't want to be with me, but you in my house. So
that's not what I said. You're still looking at it from the other end.
I'm trying to understand. Let me get some understanding. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Let me try to get some standing. Okay. Try to get some standing.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't want to be with me. You come move in with me because I got a house and you was in somewhere down there where the hurricane was and you ain't got nowhere to stay no more. So you coming up here. Now, me, at the goodness of my heart, I let you come move in with me. And then I'm looking at it like, okay, your time's starting to get up. You know what I'm saying? They done drained your house down there. You know, you was in a third story apartment up top. So ain't none of your stuff wet. You just don't want to go back. Okay. You don't want to pay no bills. But you ain't paying that because you were me, because I'm thinking that you was down on the bottom and you ain't got nothing. I'm thinking your bed was floating going across the room like this.
Really?
You know what I'm saying? So I wouldn't want to go into that thing knowing that you was a homosexual. But what you do as the homosexual, you would come at me and be like, you know, I'm feeling you a little bit more these last couple of weeks, you know. You know, and I just think that it's something there, you know. And then that's when you come in and we sitting up there, we watching TV. I'm looking at whatever on TV, you know, a Tyler Perry movie, because you know that's always on BET.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at Tyler Perry movie, and you come, you sit on the couch beside me, eating some popcorn out of my kitchen that I done bought, and you come and you put your head right here.
Lay your head on my shoulder.
And you bring the popcorn. And you bring the popcorn and you sit it right there, like on the inside of my thigh, so you can put your hand in the popcorn. And while you acting like you looking at the movie, your hand don't hit the popcorn, your hand hit my.
Okay.
Me as a man, you told me you feeling me. I'm looking, I'm like, damn, she cute. I ain't with nobody. She ain't with nobody.
Oh, now she cute because she positioned.
No, she was already cute. That's why I let her move in.
Uh-huh.
Cause a lot of homosexuals are women or men that have friend zoned somebody already beforehand. And then when they need them, the person still kind of like them and digging them a little bit. So they use them to get what they need out of them.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where that come from. You know, and then next thing you know, boom, there it is. You're in a relationship. You're in a homosexual relationship. You know?
All right.
So you have been one. I mean, had one.
Yes.
You know, I think I have too. I think I have too.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I got used with it because I was right out of my divorce and it was me and my two kids, and she was telling me she was going to help me with the kids while I was at work because they were young. They were still, mm-hmm. you know, young. So I'm like, okay, you know, when they get off the bus from school, you going to be here. Cause you ain't working, so you're gonna be here to open the door for them. Cool. Oh, you go. Oh, okay. I can go ahead and work a little bit later. I can finish that job I was on because I was doing plumbing then.
Uh huh.
I can go ahead and finish that job that I was on.
Uh huh.
I had to worry about rushing to get home by 3:15, 3:20 to meet them off the bus, so I can finish that job because I know you there with them. Oh, and you gonna cook dinner for them? I thought I had a live-in nanny.
Pretty much.
Then I realized, I'm like, wait, hold up. You doing this, but then you telling folks that you're my old lady. How you gonna be my old lady and I ain't getting no cootie?
So that's a requisite for being your old lady?
You got to. How you gonna be in a relationship without sex? You can't tell me you will be in a relationship with no sex.
I did not say that I would. But there are relationships out there that are sexless.
Who are they? The monks? The nuns?
No, they could be going through some things.
They could be what?
They could be going through some things.
Only thing they need to be going through is some.
Ew.
Or. Hey, I'm just, I keep,
you so
I
nasty.
Keep it all the way 100.
You nasty.
Nasty is what nasty does. So, all right. So that's what it is. You ain't going to be in no relationship without it. You got a lot of homosexuals in relationships. You do. You do. So I got a question for you. I saw yes. that. I got a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you could ever be a homosexual?
No.
Why not?
Because I'm too independent.
I understand you say you're independent. But if you, this is a form of homosexuality that I feel like a lot of people could fall into that would be pretty good to do. Like, okay, you're independent.
Mm-hmm.
You have your own business. You got somebody that said, hey, come on, you come on over here. Don't worry about going to that job that you go to every day that your computer dings 20 hours out of the day from, and just leave that alone. Come on over here. I got you. You work on your dream.
Okay. You work on your
dream. Is that considered a homosexual?
No, not if if you're going into that's an arrangement.
But you sexual.
Okay, but I still won't call them a hobosexual.
So what would that be called? Because I'm saying, like, you don't like this person, you don't like this dude, but he got the money to supply everything you need while you build what you want. So you gonna go over there and do it, and you know, every now and again you're gonna drop them draws for. Bust it wide open.
Well,
act like we're killing the sale.
That is a mutual agreement. There is no confusion as to what's going on right there.
So, it is a mutual agreement,
mm-hmm,
that he would pay for your dream and you will bust it open for him.
If that's what they want to do.
Would that wouldn't be homosexuality?
No.
That'd be prostitution.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Aha. What he said on Coming to America? Aha. So, with that being said, I'm not gonna sit here and I ain't gonna cap no more. You know, it is what it is. They do what they do. I have lost my notes because somebody texted me talking about this show. All right. Do you think, because I'm going back to my notes now, do you think that we have some celebrity homosexuals?
Of course. Celebrity is not going to change who you are in that area.
So who could be a celebrity homosexual? I know one famous celebrity homosexual.
Who?
Stedman. Oprah's boy.
Oh my gosh. I forgot about him.
That man ain't never had no job. He never did nothing. All you know is every now and again he pop up with her and he do whatever she say, then he go back in the hiding.
Yeah, we haven't seen him in a minute. Are they even still together?
Because he plays his role.
I ain't seen him in years.
He plays his role. He step out when he needs to step out, and he jump back in when he needs to jump in. He does exactly what he needs to do.
Well,
hey, it is what it do. Okay, what about a lot of these little young rappers? You think they like homosexuals?
Yeah. Because the thing is, like, a lot of these young rappers, they get this money that they've never had before, and then they want to flaunt it around and throw it around to all these beautiful women and so forth. And so these beautiful women are going to let them do it. So they ain't working or nothing. They're having sex, and they getting everything they want.
So they're having sex. They're getting everything they want. They're doing it just like that.
Yep. They're doing it and doing it and doing it well.
So it's crazy how some of these so-called homosexuals are out there and they making things happen, right?
Mm-hmm.
These celebrities, it's a lot of female celebrities that's homosexuals too. Look at your girl Britney Spears. Britney, she's fighting to try to be independent now on her own, and she hadn't even got it. And hell, she was doing shows and stuff 13, 14 years and ain't got nothing to show from it. Like, no,
yeah, she
knows nothing about her business. She signs nothing. She does nothing. But
which
that's her dad.
Really sad.
But that was her dad doing that. Now, I was listening to a friend of mine on another station earlier, and she pointed out something good. She was like, what if her dad was protecting her by holding this money back? And when she actually gets it, she is way more rich, or way richer, or however you say it, got a whole hell of a lot more money than she thought she had.
Mm.
Because he has been protecting her investment. That's something to think about. Something to think about.
Yeah.
But today, man, we're not talking about that. We're talking about homosexuals and these folks that's out there giving you their goods just so they can have somewhere to lay their head. They laying that head in your bed.
So I mean, but you know, if whomever they with is okay with it, then who are we to judge?
I mean, it is what it is. All right, so let's just go back over the show, man. We talked about a whole lot of stuff up here today, man. We gonna start the new segment in the nude, because what?
Because we are bearing it all.
Oh, yeah, you weren't paying attention. You were supposed to catch that point. Let's try that one more time. See, y'all, that's a new segment, so we're trying to get it together. In the nude, because we are
bearing it all.
Look at her. She's smiling. Yes, her ears. Yes, her ears. Hey, she's so funny, y'all. Hey, but yeah, in the nude, it's going to be a new segment, man. We're going to talk about some stuff that's going on in the news, but we're going to let it all out. It's going to be the nasty, nasty in the nude. Might be some, we might even talk about some celebrities that got that shit.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah. We might even break down and do some stuff like that famous comedian that's on that morning show that talk about folks all the time. There's two of them that I follow. One of them I know.
Ricky Smiley.
No, I wasn't talking about him. I was talking about his big brother. Big Who brother Steve.
Oh, Steve Harvey?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. All right, so we're gonna we'll probably start doing some crazy stuff like that, but we're gonna break down that in the nude. Today in the nude, we talked about my man R. Kelly going to jail. Yeah, he in there finna get bust wide open because he did that. My girl Kelly Price, she is still alive. She just had COVID and she is recovering. So y'all keep her in y'all prayers, man, because that's what she need to get through it. All right.
Mm-hmm.
And my hero, Will Smith, and his beautiful wife Jada, who is my next girlfriend. They don't believe in monogamy in the marriage, so why do I have to hide it? I'm going to get her.
You're going to get her.
I'm going to get her. Jada, call me, inbox me. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. Hell, follow me on Instagram. Follow me on TikTok. I'm even on TikTok. All of them are the same. At WhiteBreadTheDJ. At WhiteBreadTheDJ on all social media. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, all of them.
All right.
Don't forget, each and every Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Central, you got your girl, Miss Yak, over there right there with that show, Girl Talk. Every Tuesday. Yeah, and she will be doing it big. Man, she got a lot. If y'all hadn't checked Girl Talk out, man, y'all are missing out on a treat, because Miss Yak goes in and she breaks down all kinds of topics that y'all women be wanting to hear. And some of us men need to hear. so that we know can kind of understand y'all a little bit better, because all y'all ain't really all that crazy. But y'all halfway there. So if we can understand and get about halfway crazy with y'all, we're gonna be on the same page. All right, so y'all don't forget to check out Girl Talk every Tuesday, 8 p.m. Central Standard Time. And you got one more. Got one more. Two-time loser is coming up very soon on Big Mouth Radio. It's gonna be a full radio show. Two-time loser, the podcast will be on Big Mouth Radio. Two-time loser, the radio show will be on Parental Advisory Radio, Blazing 420 Radio. Yeah, it's two stations, one show. Yeah, follow me on TikTok. I'm gonna start doing some mixes, man. I just reached my 1,000 followers on TikTok, so I can go live. So woo-hoo! I will be going live on TikTok. I will be DJing, giving y'all a TikTok party. TikTok ain't gonna shut me down like Instagram and Facebook do, I hope. So that's the way we're gonna do it, man. We're gonna ride it out and we're gonna have a good time. So follow me on TikTok at WhiteBreadTheDJ. Follow Miss Yak at Miss_Yak on everything, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Bebo, MySpace, Black Planet. And on what you're on
the don't do me like that.
Hey man, we had a good show today, man. I appreciate y'all. Don't be getting mad because you're on OnlyFans, sweetie. It is what it is.
Don't do me.
I enjoy watching your new material.
Don't expect your business onto me.
I enjoy your new content. I got a daughter in college. I think I'm gonna get me an OnlyFans page so I can make some money, because she asks for money every other day. But yo, it is the CIg Gnac Show. I'm your guy, DJ White Bread, and this is my girl,
Miss Yak.
And we will see y'all next week when the topic of the show will be the dating game. It's all a game until somebody catch feelings.
Ooh, ooh.
All right, man. We'll see y'all next week.